In this video, I'm going to show you how to create an offline fallback for your Ruby on Rails app. So by that, I mean like if you were to turn off your Rails server, it would be able to fall back to this. And we're going to do this by just installing a gem called serviceworker-rails. So in a traditional request, when a user wants to use your application, they'll make a request to the internet and that will return HTML, maybe some JavaScript and some CSS. When a service worker comes into play, that request will go through this little JavaScript file, which we send to them. And it will say, okay, do I want to use the cached file I've seen before for this request, or do I want to route it through to the internet? So once you have that power, the internet can go out and the app will still look like it's running. So you could potentially serve like a cached version of a page or something, like a really hard cache. It has a few glitches though. So first off, you always have to use the same URL for them, otherwise it gets really confusing to register and unregister them. If you're using a Webpacker dev server locally, you can't use it. It will just give you such a hard time. When I was writing this, it was annoying. And you can only cache about 25 megs safely. Anything more than that, then you'll just start seeing like errors on different environments. Let's jump in. We're going to get started by using a gem to add the files in and get us going. We're not going to stick with this by the end of the tutorial, but this will get you into like a really good place just to kind of like learn about service workers and save yourself a bit of a kerfuffle. So let's start by adding it to our gem file. So you need it here. So if I do bundle add, and then service worker rails. Cool, that's done. And they've got an automated setup. So we just have to run this command and it will add the files we need. Fantastic. Let's go look at these files. We're going to start with this application.js. Let's have a look at what it changed there. Okay. So you can see it has added a service worker companion file. So let's have a look at that. There it is. So this is the file which is going to be run in the browser when the user requests the web page for the first time. And all we're going to pretty much do is say, hey, if you can do service workers, here's our service worker and tell us you've registered it. And if you have a quick look at that service worker code, which is just below it, it's quite like a full-on little file. We're not going to spend too much time on this because there's a much more efficient way, which I'm going to show you in the next tutorial. But what this is pretty much doing is saying, hey, go download our main assets and this offline HTML file, which is that one there. And when the browser goes to fetch some content, if it fails for whatever reason, then return the offline.html file. So nothing too fancy there. And then we also have a couple of initializers here. We have a little initializer here, which has been set, which is, I'm not quite sure what that does. I think it just sets the right headers and stuff for our files, but we don't have to worry about it for this tutorial. But if we actually see this working, here's our kind of page going. If I do inspect element, click application, we can see we have a service worker running in here. And if we go to about debugging, this may be different in your browser. We can actually see a service worker's there and registered. And if we were to refresh that, we can potentially see some output coming in here if we're lucky. Maybe. However, the key thing is our storage here. It's totally downloaded a bunch of files. So if I was to turn off my Rails server now and refresh the page, it's just fallen back to the offline page, which is pretty good.